Going to show you guys how to transfer an image to a rock. This will be handy for those who have trouble hand drawing for the weekly painting challenge, especially when it's a more complex drawing like it is this week. The items you'll need is a rock, obviously, primed white, preferably, because you'll be using graphite and the white makes it show up a lot better, as well as needing some tracing paper. Any type will do, as long as you can obviously see through it. Some sort of device that has a screen, or phone. I'll give alternatives when I get into this if you don't want to use a device to do this, but this is how I do it. A pencil and some tape. Make sure the pencil is actual graphite. Charcoal will also work, but it's a way messier. So, device-wise, I'm using a tablet, Android, and you'll need a particular program. Now, I don't know an alternative to this for Apple. I haven't touched an Apple phone in years, but I would imagine there is one. It just not might be free, because Apple doesn't give anything for free anymore. So, on an Android device, the app you're looking for is called Paper Copy. It's free. It has only one little small ad, and that's it. No special permissions or anything like that, so it's a pretty safe app, and like I said, free. And of course, you'll need the image for this week's paint challenge, or whatever you want to trace. And you can get that by using the Facebook app and just going to the image and selecting download. So, got your image. I like to invert the image to make it mirrored before it comes out how it's supposed to. Get your trace paper out. I like to make an outline of the rock that I'm going to use, for I know not to oversize my image beyond the size of the rock. So cut out, doesn't have to be pretty. Then tape it to your device using transparent tape. You want to make sure it's nice and taut. You don't want it to wrinkle too much moving around, especially if you're going to get your hand on it. So the more tape you put down, the better. Don't worry about the tape on the screens. At the max, you'll have a residue that washes off pretty easy. So for my Android, I'm going to be using that paper copy app, like I said. Some alternatives is to print out the image and just tape it to a window with on a sunny day or with a light behind it, and trace it like you would back in elementary school. Guess you could also do it on a older monitor that still has glass instead of plastic. I mean, there's options. Any hard glass thing that you can tape to with the image behind it should technically work while using tracing paper. So you have options. I just like this because it's portable, easy, and it's what I have. So open up the app. The cool thing about the app is you can shrink the image to where you need it to fit the outline of the rock. And now time for some speed art. And obviously you don't need to be really detailed about what you're getting here. This is just for a general outline. Make sure you're careful taking off the tape too, because that trace paper will rip very easily. I could live with that. So at this point, you're done with the tablet, unless you need for more reference. And the fun part. So now you need to get that under there. I preferably like to cut this down, the paper down more to give a smaller border around them. Just makes it where you can have more space to tape. Voila! You have your trace paper on the rock. It's time to trace it again. Now, you want to be careful, especially if it's not a perfectly smooth rock, to not push too hard where you just gouge out the paper. So, you want to put pressure as much as you can without destroying the tracing paper. So, it can be a little touch and go. You'll get a feel for it eventually. Another option you can do is if you have a dotting tool or anything that is smooth and round, you could just press along the edges. It's not quite as effective, but it does work enough to get the job done. Okay, all done with the retrace. Now it's time to take off the tape. You don't have to be so careful about it this time because you pretty much can't reuse this, especially if you accidentally gone through the tracing paper at any point of doing this. I tried reusing them before in the past and it kind of just ends up messy, so tear this sucker off. Now, it's kind of hard to see it through my camera, but it's there quite boldly. Well, not super boldly, but boldly enough that I can see where I need the paint. So the camera is not picking it up quite as good as I hoped, but let's see here. See if I can get it to show up. It is a little bit better, but it's there, lightly, and if you really needed this to be darker, you could always go over it with a pencil again, but it is darn near a perfect replica of what I started out with, minus the really fine details that I can just add in later. There's probably way simpler ways to go about this, but this is what I do, it's what I like to do, it's been handy in the past for the more complex paintings to do. Hope this helps you guys to be able to join in the weekly challenge. I would like to see more people doing it, that's for sure. So, if you feel like giving this a run, feel like a challenge, join in. It's not a contest. It's just about having fun and to do stuff like this, teach each other new techniques, how to go about making art. So, feel free to comment if you got questions. I'll try to answer them as best as I can, and yada yada yada. Have fun.